Hi everyone, welcome to AR Study Desk. Today, we'll be studying the topic orthographic projection. Orthographic projection is nothing but the representation of 3D objects in 2D. It is a form of parallel projection in which the line of sight will be perpendicular to the plane of projection. So since it is perpendicular to the plane of projection, it is called orthographic projection. So if you want to locate something in space, you need some reference, am I right? For example, a point 2, 3 in a graph sheet, it means that it is on the x-axis, you have to take 2 units, and on the y-axis, you have to take 3 units. Similarly, in engineering graphics, particularly in orthographic projection, we have 3 types of planes: the horizontal plane, vertical plane, and profile plane. For the time being, we'll be taking only the first 2 planes, that is horizontal plane and vertical plane. So horizontal plane is, which is also called HP, will be horizontal like this. Now VP or vertical plane will be perpendicular to HP. Now this is a person who is viewing from here such that the line of sight is perpendicular to VP. So this view is called front view, also called elevation. Now there is a line at the intersection of HP and VP and it is called XY line. So for this person, X will be on his left and Y will be on his right. Now this space is divided by these 2 reference planes into 4 quadrants. So they are first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Now for this person, the 2 quadrants which are above HP, so this is HP, and for him the 2 quadrants above HP are 1 and 2. Similarly, the 2 quadrants which are below HP are 3 and 4. Also, this is vertical plane VP, and these 2 quadrants, that is 2 and 3, are behind VP, and 1 and 4 are in front of VP when you view from here. So, the 2 quadrants which are in front of VP are 1 and 4, and the 2 quadrants which are behind VP are 2 and 3. So let us revise this. The 2 quadrants above HP are 1 and 2, the 2 quadrants below HP are 3 and 4, the 2 quadrants in front of VP are 1 and 4, the 2 quadrants behind VP are 2 and 3. Now, let us see how to represent these quadrants with respect to the XY line. For example, see, when we are drawing this on a sheet, that is when we draw the projections, we don't usually draw this HP and VP, we'll be drawing only this XY line. So we'll see how these quadrants are with respect to XY line. Now when the person is viewing the front view, the 2 quadrants above HP are 1 and 2 that we discussed before. So these 2 quadrants will be above the XY line for him, am I right? So this is the XY line, and these 2 quadrants will be above the XY line when he is viewing from here. Similarly, the 2 quadrants 3 and 4 which are below HP will be below the XY line for him, correct? Now let us see the top view. So this is the top view, and this top view has another name which is called plan. We used to draw the plan of buildings, houses, etc. The 2 quadrants which are behind VP are 2 and 3. So these 2 quadrants appears to be above the XY line for him when he is viewing from here. Am I right? So when he is viewing from here, this is the XY line, and second and third quadrants which are behind VP will be above the XY line for him. Correct? Similarly, the two quadrants which are in front of VP, that is first quadrant and fourth quadrant, will be below the XY line for him. So the two quadrants which are in front of VP, that is first quadrant and fourth quadrant, will be below the XY line for him when he is viewed from the top. So let us see an example. Orthographic projection of a point A which is 10 mm above HP and 15 mm in front of VP. 10 mm above HP means the point can either be in the first quadrant or in the second quadrant, because above HP means first and second quadrant. Now, if in the question, if it is in front of VP, the point will be in the first quadrant. And if in the question, if it is behind VP, it will be in the second quadrant. So here it is given that the point is 15 mm in front of VP. So it is above HP and in front of VP. That means it is in the first quadrant, like this. Now, this is the front view. The person is now viewing the front view. The line of sight is coming like this. So it will hit this point and we'll get the projection on VP. That point is represented as A dash. Our point is capital A, and the front view of that point will be represented as small a dash. So if the point is B, capital B, its front view will be small b dash. Okay, so we get the front view projected on VP. Front views are always projected on VP. Now, let us see how we should represent this on a paper. So, draw the XY line. So, where is this point A dash? It is above XY line. So, how much distance above XY line? It is 10 mm above XY line. Am I right? So, draw a very light line and mark the point A dash. This length is nothing but 10 mm. Now we'll be viewing the top view. Here the point is in front of VP. So as we studied before, the two quadrants which are in front of VP will be seen below the XY line in the top view. So if you project this, you get the projection on HP and you represent it as small a. So if the point is capital A, the projection that we get on HP, that is the top view, will be represented by small letter of that particular point. So capital A is our point, the projection on HP, that is the top view, will be small a. So top views will be projected on HP. We'll see how to draw this on the sheet. So it is below the XY line for this person, correct? How much mm below XY line? It is 15 mm in front of VP. So this distance is 15 mm. So it will be 15 mm below the XY line. So look at here. Draw a 15 mm line, very light line, and mark the point and then mark the dimension. Okay, this is how we represent this point, which is 10 mm above HP and 15 mm in front of VP on a sheet. Okay, so these two lines, they are called the projection line or projector. This point, dark point A, and this dark point A dash, they are called projections. Now this is called the extension line and this is the dimension line. Thank you for watching. Happy learning.